Please stand for a salute to the flag. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
What is up, Conf? Today is November 5th, 2014. I'm Bailey Rosemeyer.
And I'm Ryan Patella, and it's time for KTV Live Bon Appetit.
So, Ryan, we have a great show, a bunch of great segments.
We do, and I am pumped up.
I'm very excited, so you know what?
Let's get into the news.
Let's get into it. Today's KTV holiday is Guy's Fawkes Day. Guy's Fawkes Day is a day to celebrate bonfires and fireworks. This holiday started in 1605 when a guy was arrested guarding explosives under the House of Lords. It originated in Canada. Please always use fireworks and fire with adult supervision.
Reminder, there is no homework club for this week. Homework club resumes Monday, November 10th.
Today's rockin' KTV birthday is the talented Nick Jonas. Nick Jonas is the lead guitarist of world-renowned boy band The Jonas Brothers, says FamousBirthdays.com. In 2009, Disney released the original series Jonas, featuring Nick and his two other brothers. Nick was born in New Jersey and is turning 27 today.
Attention students looking to compete in the annual statewide Science Olympiad competition. Interest forms are due to Mrs. Bohuniak on Monday. If you need a new form, see Mrs. Vikshans or Mrs. Bohuniak.
All right, Nick, so you are here with the sports today.
Okay, I have some sports news. So, in the NBA, the Trailblazers beat the Cavaliers 101-82.
Wow.
The Rockets also beat the Heat 108-91.
All right, that's not really a close game. Never mind.
And in the NHL, the Penguins beat the Wild 4-1.
Oh, that's not a good game, I guess. I don't know.
And the Blackhawks beat the Canadiens 5-0.
They killed them. Wow.
I know.
All right.
So sad.
I guess we're going to get back into the news.
This week is Israeli Week. KosherCertification.com states that the process of kosher certification has been radically affected by deep changes in the food industry.
In our area are the Deli of Clark, Larry's Kosher Deli Restaurant, Cubby Springfield Kosher Deli, and La Caldera Kosher Restaurant.
According to DeliKingOfClark.com, Deli King of Clark is located on 30 Clarkton Drive, Clark, New Jersey. According to PostGazette.com, one of the Deli King of Clark specialties is kosher food.
Larry's Kosher Deli is located on 2549 Amsterdam Avenue.
According to LevinesKosher.com, Larry's Kosher Restaurant has everything kosher, from kugels to cakes.
According to Yahoo.com, Cubby Springfield Kosher Deli is located on 779 Mountain Ave, Springfield, New Jersey.
According to MenuPicks.com, Cubby Springfield Kosher Deli sells sandwiches, subs, and deli.
La Caldera Kosher Deli is located on 263 Morris Ave, Springfield, New Jersey.
According to Shabbat.org, kosher foods are fit for Jewish consumption.
In kosher dining, there are certain foods that people cannot eat. What ingredients can you usually use in kosher dining? Is it A, meat and fish together? Possibly B, sweets with meats? Or maybe C, batters and breadings? In kosher dining, you can't cook with certain foods matched with other foods. And the answer is C, batters and breadings. If the foods are not blessed by the rabbi, they cannot be eaten on Passover. Kosher dining is a strict food policy that strict Jewish people follow. All right.
So, Bailey,
we
have our first break in the show over there with Rocky. So let's throw it over to him.
Thank you, guys. So we have the 11th annual holiday.
All Hi, Rocky. What's up?
So, my mic wasn't really working. I don't know why.
That's all right.
But we have the 11th Annual Holiday Winter Festival, and it's Sunday, November 30th from 3 to 6 o'clock. Make sure you bring your own camera so you can get your picture with Santa Claus.
Awesome. That's very exciting.
Pictures with Santa Claus.
I love it.
It doesn't get better.
I vote, like, Rocky, goodbye. We're going to get back into the news. Awesome. Okay.
See you.
Recently, there have been many events happening at the Clark Public Library. What movie is playing at the Clark Public Library on the 23rd? Is it A, How to Train Your Dragon 2? Or how about B, Shrek? Or lastly, could it be C, The Muppets? This movie is rated PG. And the answer is A, How to Train Your Dragon. How to Train Your Dragon 2 is about a boy named Hiccup and a dragon named Toothless who journey through the skies. While flying around, they discover a secret ice cave, which is home to many dragons. This movie starts at 2 and ends at 3:45. The movie is a family-friendly movie.
There will be a meeting for all NJHS members on Thursday, November 13th at 7:40 in Room 4. Officer meetings will be Monday at 7:40.
So Bailey, I am here with the weather.
Awesome.
So I'm going to be quick. So today will be cloudy with a high of 64.
All right.
Tomorrow will be rainy with a high of 55.
Oh, it's going to be cold tomorrow.
It's going to be very, very cold.
I like it.
Friday will be rainy again with a high of 54.
All right.
And then finally Saturday, it will be sunny with a high of 52.
All right. So this week it keeps getting colder and colder.
It's going to be very cold, yeah. But I mean,
you know,
it's going to be nice.
Fall.
So let's get into it.
Bye.
Comf Infinity blog, there will be a meeting on Tuesday for all current members and new blog reporters. We'll be starting a new mobile project soon.
PALS is a club here at Comf. Ryan got a chance to interview the head of PALS, Mr. Falco, and some students to see why PALS is a good club.
How many 7th and 8th grade PALS do you have this year, and what have they done so far?
We've had a lot of 7th and 8th graders come out to help the 6th graders get used to life at home.
What are the requirements to join PALS?
In order to join PALS, you have to be in 7th or 8th grade and submit an application. You also need to be a model student, maintaining good grades.
What is PALS?
PALS is a program that helps 6th graders adjust to middle school life here at Comf. It's run by 7th and 8th graders, and it stands really for peer leadership.
I think PALS is a good club because it helps interact with 6th graders and help them adjust to culture.
I think PALS is a good club because it really gets the 6th graders used to 6th grade.
You can join PALS when you are in 7th or 8th grade. All right, Ryan, we have our last break in the show.
We do.
It's coming to an end. It's unfortunate, but Luke is over there, so let's check it out.
So, guys, on Monday, we have our next show because we have a 4-day weekend. We have an interview. On a movie that's coming out, and we have a birthday on a former child TV star. So let's pass it back to you guys.
All right, I'm very excited.
Learning about a picture with Santa Claus, I mean,
that's exciting.
Doesn't
stuff.
Get better.
Okay, so for even more KTV news, don't forget to subscribe to us on Facebook, Twitter, or YouTube. For Ryan Patella and the rest of the KTV News team, I'm Bailey Rosemeyer. Have a great day and 4-day weekend.